afternoon for both clubs. Defeat for Rangers would mean losing four consecutive home games in a turbulent run, which has seen them go out of the European Champions Cup and the Coca-Cola League Cup. Ibrox Stadium looking magnificent as ever. The official capacity these days, 46,836. And certainly a lot of work has been going on downstairs. The Rangers very hopeful that they will host a European Cup final sooner than later. But they have to improve on the record of this season. That reads, played 7, won 3 and lost 4, which is certainly bad news for manager Walter Smith. Hearts have played 5 matches, winning just a 1 against Dumbarton in the League Cup. They've also drawn 1 game and lost 3, including League Cup elimination at the hands of St Johnson. So it's a day for both sets of players to stand up and be counted. Alan McInally.
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's, with being a live game as well, Jared, it brings upon its own pressures, not only with their great rivals across the city sitting at the top of the league. I think this mini crisis that's going through Rangers at the moment, and I say mini, I don't think there is, okay, the biggest crisis obviously is losing in the Champions League, but I think they can get back on the rails today.
Well, Walter Smith has told his players to go in the same type of unbeaten run which has destroyed the opposition in recent seasons. You can't just turn it on and off though, can you?
No, absolutely, no, you can't. I mean, you can't. I mean, Rangers had a tremendous couple of years, you know, winning everything. Certainly almost everything. And, you know, there's teams that you can go through times like this where, you know, you're going to lose games. The only unfortunate thing, like I say, for Rangers, I think losing to Falkirk can be, you know, possibly explainable, but the problem was losing the Champions League where they can get most of their revenue. They're looking to buy top-class players again to strengthen the team, and I think that was the biggest disappointment. But like I say, I think they'll get back on the rails today, although, again, Hearts have got so much to play for. They're at the wrong end of the league. OK, Tom McLean hasn't got a great deal of money to spend. The Taylor report says they have to get their stadium up to patch, you know, so it's a bit of a learning process for him. But I still think Rangers will take the 3 points today.
So Rangers coming onto the field, led out by their skipper, Richard Goff, and receiving a warm ovation from the much criticised support. McLean just can turn this one around today, and I'm sure it'll get around very well. But as Alan said, Hearts have a lot to prove as well. You're sitting bottom of the Premier Division. And of course, two teams could be relegated this season because of the playoff situation. Well, there's Richard Goff, who's chasing his 7th consecutive Premier League medal. Joined Rangers from Spurs back in 1987. It's been constant success, but now facing up to his greatest challenge, the man who won 61 caps for Scotland before quitting the international arena last year. Well, if we can have a look at the teams, Rangers make just the one change from the side which lost to Falkirk in the Coca-Cola Cup. Neil Murray comes in for Gordon Jury, who's on the bench along with Duncan Ferguson. And Hearts are without defender Stephen Frail, who's suspended after being ordered off in the League Cup defeat by St Johnson. A hefty blow that for Hearts, who were 2-0 ahead at home before losing out to the Perth Saints. Well, three changes from that side with Scott Leach, Mo Johnson, who of course earned his money here for a couple of years, and Tosh McKinley. They come in to replace Frail, Weir and Alan Johnson, who's on the bench. So just waiting for the appearance of Hearts now, led out there by Alan McLaren, who had such a good game in midweek. There is some speculation, Alan McInally, he might play that international role for Hearts this afternoon.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. He's come off a tremendous performance for Scotland in that area of the park. And I don't really see any reason for Tommy to change away if the players can play around about him exactly the way the Scotland team did them. I think there's every chance of possibly getting something from this game, because you know, he's a very, very important member for the team for Hearts.
Well, Fortress Ibrox, as it was called, has lost that tag, certainly for the moment. Rangers had a run of almost two seasons undefeated here. But last season they'd lost 3 league games before the end of October. This season they've lost 3 games by the end of August. So much to prove this afternoon. Hearts certainly don't have the best of records against Rangers. It's 15 games ago since they last won. That was on August the 17th, 1991, when Scott Crabb scored the only goal of the game, almost from the kickoff, as we saw earlier in the programme. In fact, just the one win in more than 4 years. So the referee calling the skippers together, Jim McCluskey from Stewarton, who handled last October's League Cup final, in which Rangers defeated Hibernian by 2-1. And 6 days later, he was in charge here at Ibrox in the league game, which Rangers lost to Celtic by 2-1. Mr. McCluskey, in fact, handled no fewer than 5 Rangers games last season, and 5 involving Hearts, so he certainly knows the players of both sides. Well, Rangers chasing their 45th Scottish Championship. For Hearts, it's been 32 long years since their last trophy victory. So this large crowd settles down for what we all hope will be an afternoon of some entertainment. Season 1992-93, Rangers put a 30-game run together without losing a league game, and last season, after a poorish start, they put together 17 games unbeaten, and that really did win them the championship. That's what Walter Smith is calling for this afternoon. And there's Mo Johnson, who'll no doubt get a warm welcome alongside John Robertson. And hard to believe now that Mo Johnson has put his international career behind him, because Duncan Shearer, who's forging a new career, is actually 8 months older than Mo. But a man who scored 15 goals for his country in 38 appearances. Certainly did very well for Scotland. But this afternoon, it's all about what he does for Hearts as the match gets underway. So it's Berry clipping it forward. Headed away there by Robertson. A touch for McLaren, who is indeed well forward. John Miller, in fact, has dropped back to look after Mark Hatley. So McLaren indeed is playing in the type of role he fulfilled in midweek in Finland for the Scotland team. And here's Hatley. Still through by Durant to Ian Ferguson. It's McCall. There is Miller. This is Ian Ferguson now for Rangers. It's Robertson. Running away from Durant, though, there's Laudrup in there, but losing out. Now a touch for Tosh McKinley. Trying to get away from Murray. Robertson. He's well challenged by Craig Moore. Long one through now for Hatley. Levine's under pressure here. Down goes Hatley. The referee shakes his head. Still it's Hatley, battling away. It breaks out to Laudrup. Well, that was quite remarkable, because Craig Levein is a player known for his pace, and he was really under pressure there from Hatley.
Superb pace by Big Mark to get in front of, well, almost in front of Craig. Craig actually did it well eventually, just kind of bundled him to the ground. It was a good decision by the referee. It wasn't a penalty, but again, signs of Mark Hatley's looking for more goals this year as they did last year.
Well, one or two people suggesting that Hatley perhaps going off the boil, but certainly on that evidence, he looks very much in the mood this afternoon. So a free kick to Hearts, and it's Levine over the ball. He's got Tosh McKinley in a bit of space out there. Murray's a bit late to react. It's headed away by Goff. This is McCall. Laudrup, nice touch by Laudrup, getting the ball away from Miller. Now Ian Ferguson playing it through, looking for Hatley. Across comes Berry with the sliding challenge, and a good one it was by the big Hearts defender. This is Laudrup. Picture a ton from McCall. The early cross. Durant's in a bit of space. It's Hatley. It's Durant again.
Hearts don't want to be giving Brian Laudrup as much space in the flanks as that. Again, you already see how good a ball he can deliver into the box. And again, another opportunity for Rangers to score. They have to mark him a lot tighter than that.
Henry Smith back in the fold this afternoon, replacing Nicky Walker in goal. And that's McCall now, putting the ball through, looking for the pace of Robertson, but Levine responds. Now it's Cahoon. Oh, John Cahoon in his second spell at Hearts, taking on former Hearts player McPherson. And well handled by Gorham. John Robertson in close attendance. Well, good play that by John Cahoon, being pursued all the way by McPherson. And Robertson not far away from that one. Gorham responding.
Well, that will give the Hearts fans and the Broomloan stand something to cheer about. Meanwhile, it's Durant for Rangers. That's Craig Moore to Goff. Long one for Hatley. Tried to find Loudrup, but not standing firm. This is McLaren. That's Cahoon. Well, Ali McLaren, very much in the area that Ian Ferguson inhabits, and this will be a real good tussle between those two today, because Ferguson, along with this man McCall, very much the engine of the Rangers team. And Ian Ferguson, a player who likes to shoot from 20 yards out, so McLaren keeping a very close watch on him in the midfield area. Meanwhile, it's McPherson for Rangers. There is Ferguson, McLaren moving in to meet him. Switch of play to McCall. Ferguson again, trying to find Loudrup, but he sets John Miller. Now it's Berry. Boone floats a high one forward, but to no great avail. Trying to pick out John Robertson there, but they're all running away from the little Hearts striker.
I think that's true what you said, Jerry, about Alan McLaren playing in there. I think it's also to stifle a little bit of the possession and passing that Ferguson and McCall can give Rangers. And obviously with his own contribution to Hearts, hoping that, and in turn, he can produce something for Hearts in turn, rather than letting Rangers dictate the play as much as they do at home.
This is Miller. Played into the feet of Robertson. He's quickly challenged by Goff. This is McLaren stepping in for Hearts. Now it's Tosh McKinley. But the offside flag going up. And the Hearts player's not at all happy with the decision. This is Goff to Ian Ferguson. Having to play the ball early again because of McLaren. This is McCall.
And that.
Durant trying to open things up here. Good play by Durant. But the offside flag is up as Loudrup breaks through. Good close control.
It's gone straight to Walters.
Durant, the kind of player who can really open things up.
Good ball, and I'd have preferred Ian Durant to have a shot there. A good shooting opportunity, but decided to rather take it wider and look for a cross in, possibly looking for Mark at the back post. But I think Ian should have maybe even thought about having a pot and goal there and test Henry Smith earlier in the game.
And back goes the ball to Henry Smith, who's involved in a real tussle with Nicky Walker for the number one jersey. It's changed hands a couple of times already this season. This is Berry. And Gary Locke has to settle for the throw-in. Just 19 years of age, but made 39 appearances last season and faced Rangers in all five games, one of the promising youngsters that Hearts have. But manager Tommy McLean making it clear that he needs money to spend on this team. He needs to bring in some fresh faces. He did such a great job at Motherwell. Built them up, now he has to do it all over again. It's Robertson trying to get through, but too many Rangers players around him, and it's David Robertson to Moore. And Craig Moore there, his third start of the season. He looks an accomplished young player. I saw him make his debut at Tannadice last season, and the Rangers have great hopes for him. Here he is again challenging. Away by Levine. Murray's in there with Leach. Breaks to Hatley. Leach blocks him. McLaren steps in. This is Tosh McKinley. Looking for Moe Johnson. Quickly closed down by Goff. Now it's Moore. Now Craig Moore being very solid indeed. And it draws applause from the Rangers fans. Now it's Loudrup. Neil Murray. Ferguson to McCall. Robertson's ahead of him. Played to Durant. goes down by Berry. Ball follows through, chipped it through. That's a good ball for Ian Durant. Levine goes to meet him. The early cross, and Henry Smith handles it well.
Good play by Rangers there. Super ball through from Shoot McCall here to Ian Durant. Had tried to play a nutmeg before. Carries on into a great position. Unfortunately, Henry can, well, fortunately for Hearts, rather, Henry gathers it quite safe enough, and they can breathe again. Signs already that Rangers are getting on top in the game.
Clearance from Moore, carefully watched by Berry, does well, finds Gary Locke. And a slip by John Robertson at the vital moment. John Robertson, who's got such a good scoring record against Rangers. We'll be keeping a particular watch on him this afternoon. Meanwhile, it's Leach trying to get forward. Losing out to Ian Ferguson, who's dropped deep. Now looking for Hatley. Looks in there ahead of Berry. Good play again by Hatley. He needs some support to arrive up. He has to check his stride, and as he tries to find Loudrup, Rangers lose possession to Miller. Well, great play by Hatley on the right-hand side, but he did no one at all running in support. Now it's Hearts on the attack. It's Josh McKinley trying to get forward with 10 minutes of the match played, and still no scoring here at Ibrox Stadium in this Premier Division match between Rangers and Hearts. And the offside flag goes up.
In a way, a kind of ghostly atmosphere today, Jerry, not just the normal fervence that they have from the Rangers supporters. I think they're waiting for their team to do something before they actually get behind them, and it's a kind of strange situation at the moment. I think I'm hoping for Rangers' sake that they can pull something off rather than their fans being on their back so early in the game.
I think one of the big worries for Walter Smith has been the lack of chances created, apart from anything else.
Well, you can see an instance there. Mark Hatley wins the header and actually got his pass to himself, I should say. You know, and he's really on his own up front there, and they'll have to get men forward to support, or like you say, you know, if you don't make chances, you're not going to be scoring goals. And certainly at home, that's what Rangers have to be doing.
And this is McCall now for Rangers. To Moore. Murray. McCall runs into an area where there was no Rangers player at all. He's followed by McLaren. This is Murray. Through for Loudrup, that's a good ball. Loudrup going in the outside of Miller. And the ball come off the feet of Neil Berry. A nice little ball played by Neil Murray through to Loudrup in the first place.
Yeah, he does really well. Just this little half step again just gives him an extra, that little bit extra time to try and get the ball in the middle. Unfortunately for them, it came to nothing.
Meanwhile, it's Hearts moving forward. Will Johnson runs onto the pass from John Robertson, supported by Tosh McKinley. It's an easy one for Gorham, no challenge whatsoever. Well, floated in there by Tosh McKinley.
Morris gets his usual warm welcome from the loving Rangers fans.
Now it's Durant. Trying for the pace of Robertson, but misplaced pass right to Berry. That's Robertson, laid off to McLaren. McKinley. Again, Moore responds well, getting in ahead of Mo Johnson. But Miller also responded well, kept that ball in play. In steps Richard Gough, the Rangers captain. McCall. Durant. Robertson starting a run on the left. That's where it goes. Well, it's Robertson. It's Hatley. It's deflected for the corner. Hatley making the ball first time. Deflected off the defender for the corner kick.
Great run from David Robertson to get into a good crossing position. Mark Hatley makes a good early post run. Does everything right. Unfortunately, just can't get on. It's well defended in the end. It's a corner for Rangers.
And it's played short by Loudrup to McCall. Back to Loudrup. David McPherson's up in the area at his height, and again the ball goes behind. This time though, it's a goal kick. And Loudrup switching over there to the left-hand side to take that corner.
He does give any team he plays with, Brian Loudrup, so many options. Like you said, you know, he switches sides there so easily, very comfortable in either feet, and can deliver super balls into the box with either feet. And I think that's one of the reasons I think Mark Haley will probably end up top goal scorer in Scotland again with the amount of chances, hopefully for himself, that Brian Laudrup can create for him.
This is McCall for Rangers. To Goff. Closed down by Robertson. This is the Rangers Robertson, David. Well, the crowd becoming a bit frustrated. Rangers trying to unpick the lock here. But Hearts have them well closed down in the middle of the park. Played off by Robertson to McLaren. Now it's Leach. Tosh McKinley. Mo Johnston. Good play by Johnson. He took a knock there. And as he was challenged by Moore, still Hearts have it. Slack play by Leach. Promising move there by Hearts. It all breaks down. But they have it back again. This is Levine. It's McLaren. Mo Johnson's calling it for it on the left-hand side, but it's played wide right to Cahoon. Gary Locke runs in support. Still it's Cahoon. Play on, says the referee. Ian Durant has taken a knock in that exchange as David Robertson breaks forward. He's challenged by McLaren. Robertson does well to keep possession. Now it's Laudrup. Bately's in the middle. Still it's Laudrup taking on Berry. Doing well, getting in the cross. The chance is on here for Murray.
Superb play by Brian Laudrup. Does brilliant. Takes that extra touch. Takes it further deeper in. Super deep cross. Misses out Mark Haley. Neil Murray in support come up. Just steered it wide. Unlucky, but a great opportunity. See a super deep cross from Brian Laudrup, and Neil Murray just come in a little bit late. Couldn't steer the ball into the net.
So 15 minutes gone now. Still no scoring here at Ibrox Stadium, but a real chance there for Neil Murray. No doubt about that. Played off by Ian Ferguson. This is McPherson. Durant. Robertson again goes in a run. It's played inside out to Laudrup. Good play by Laudrup. Robertson still motoring forwards. And the ball's behind for the goal kick. You really feel Rangers should have done better out of that.
Two great chances coming in from the left. David Robertson just under pressure a little bit from John Cahoon, does actually very well, John, in defending by putting Robertson off, and I'm sure it would have been a sure goal had the ball been played to Mark Haley's feet. Again, Brian Laudrup, instigator again, carving away through the Hearts defence.
Good running by Robertson. That's Goff's header, and Ferguson under pressure there from Leach, but Moore steps in, finds McPherson. That's McCall. Durant. Through by McPherson. A downward header from Durant to Ferguson. Good running by Durant. John Miller goes with him and responds. Rangers have the throw-in. But, Durant making up a lot of ground there. He had nodded the ball down in the midfield area and then run wide to the right to take the return. Meanwhile, it's Murray. It comes off Durant. Good play again. Finds Craig Moore. Hitley's calling for it on the far side. Just beyond him, though. And it's John Cahoon stepping in for Hearts. Still, it's Cahoon. Looking for Mo Johnson, but can defending by Craig Moore. Young man from Australia. This is McCall, Laudrup. Played through by Robertson. Laudrup again. Providing a cross for Hitley! And John Miller responds, and that's behind for the corner kick. Defending that by John Miller, he was under a lot of pressure there. Superb play out on the left, and Hitley so close.
Yeah, again, if Neil Berry is going to be doing a man-marking job, and Brian Laudrup today is going to have his hands full. As the ball's coming in, you almost think Mark just needs to header it to get it in. Good defending.
That header going in from Richard Goff. And dipping behind for the goal kick. Durant striking it well. Goff's header wide of target. Rangers skipper still to open his account this season. McPherson's header. So Berry has plenty of time here. That's Cahoon. Scott Leach. McLaren under pressure from Ian Ferguson. This is Miller. Moe Johnston. Miller again. Tosh McKinley. Moore watching him carefully. It's fine for the goal kick. Tosh McKinley feels he was impeded there. Former Celtic Boys Club player who had a spell at Dundee. Signed for them back in 1981. And he's been a good servant to Hearts since he's moved there 6 years ago. So I felt there that Moore had impeded him. But, certainly Moore showing a lot of strength in his challenges. So 20 minutes played now here at Ibrox in this Premier Division match. It's Rangers 0, Hearts 0. This is Richard Goff. Another ambitious one looking for Hatley. Crowd not over enamoured. Not the long ball through, neither I suspect is Archie Knox, the Rangers assistant manager.
You don't want to be doing that too often in the game. I mean, you're wasting energy of marks running into the corner like that when you give the ball away so easy.
Touch there from Moe Johnston, finding Robertson. He's challenged by Goff. This is Moore. Moore taking on Tosh McKinley. He did well there. He saw Murray running earlier, but he made it that bit easier for Neil Murray. This is Ferguson. That's blocked by Berry. Play through now for Miller. Robertson. Miller again. Scott Leach is going in a good run through the middle there. But he'll do well to keep that in play, especially with the attentions of Richard Goff. So it was very good running by Scott Leach, but the pass didn't quite match. Tommy McLean just below us, shaking his fist out towards his players. This is Tosh McKinley. It's Moe Johnston. And that's a corner kick to Hearts. And he was blocked there by David McPherson.
Good play, good ball in. Morris obviously loved to score here at Ibrox. I think a little bit too much. I think he had more options than actually a shot he had there, but nevertheless gets a corner for Hearts.
So Hearts pushing plenty of players into the Rangers penalty. Craig Levine's right up there on the line. This is Tosh McKinley. It's Moe Johnston. And behind for the goal kick on this occasion. Well, Moe Johnston, man of many clubs, in the thick of the action there. But, Craig Levine was well forward. It was Richard Goff who got the ball away. And Tosh McKinley going in with his head, you know, with a boot a bit high. The referee waving play on. It broke away out to Moe Johnston. But into the side netting.
Yeah, a little bit unlucky there. I think that Tosh McKinley was making sure he didn't get any studs in the face from Ian Durant. Although the ball was far too far from Morris and just couldn't direct it onto target.
So we're midway through the first half, still no scoring. It's out for the throw, two Hearts. Again, Tommy McLean out, giving some advice. This is John Robertson. Tosh McKinley, looking for the head of Moe Johnston. Nice little touch, almost finding Leach. So the Rangers get it away through David Robertson.
The super ball in from Tosh McKinley. Morris almost did it tonight. Just a little touch that he needed. No Hearts man on the end of it, unfortunately.
This is Robertson showing good control. Now it's McLaren. That one dipping harmlessly behind for the goal kick. Now Alan McLaren. player who's won youth under 21 and full caps and who played so well in Finland in midweek where he won his 13th cap. And a player very much in the transfer news at the moment. Celtic have made a bid this season already and have £1 million for him. The Rangers are also said to be showing interest. But he's a big job on his hands this afternoon. In the colours of Hearts, well, it's Mo Johnson. Ian Ferguson digging in well against Leitch, but Hearts have it again. It's Johnson. He's showing plenty of appetite for this match. It's Miller, McKinley, Johnston. Still it's Johnston.
Well, I know Morris, he won't be happy with this. Good striker, normally hits the target, but strangled his shot there, trying to hit the ball too hard. Went painfully wide. Not one of Morris's best shots on target.
So Hearts coming a little more into things after Rangers ran the show in the earlier stages, and Johnson very much in the thick of it. This is Hatley now for Rangers. Switch of play out to Durant, but just too much for him. Robertson was arriving as well, but just too late. I think Walter Smith will be happy enough with Ian Durant's performance so far, and he could be such an important player to the club in the weeks and months ahead.
I think the fact that he got back from such a bad injury was a bonus to Rangers in themselves, Jerry. Not having to go out and shell a lot of money, and a player like Ian Durant, where it would cost you £2 or 3 million to get someone of his quality.
It's Hatley's header. And again, little support. It's aimed at Mo Johnson, he gets the better of Moore. Clearance from Goff. Tosh McKinley looking for Robertson. It's McPherson's header to Goff. So Johnson, nice little touch to Robertson. Johnson going for the return. It's Johnston again. Tosh McKinley trying to get away from Moore. And on this occasion he gets a free kick. Well, he was unhappy with a challenge by Moore a few minutes ago. As the ball went behind for a goal kick. This time it's a free kick to Hearts.
Should be a good tussle today between them. Tosh always looks to go past defenders, and Craig Moore certainly no slouch. Should be a very good competition between those two guys today.
So it's John Robertson who takes the free kick, headed away by Goff, and easily taken in the end by Andy Gorham. I just question, Alan, you know, John Robertson, who's a superb goal scorer, penalty box goal scorer, and he's taking free kicks from wide areas.
Well, maybe, the unfortunate thing about it, maybe he's the one of a quality ball in the box. After all, if there's no quality coming into the box in good areas, you're not going to score. But like you say, I'd prefer, surely someone in the team can take and deliver a ball in the box and have your most prolific goal scorer where you want him to be.
This is Moore for Rangers. Murray, McCall, Miller's with him, so it's McCall battling away. That's out for the throw-in to Rangers.
For all the possession that Rangers are having, Jerry, as well, I'd like to see someone really taking a chance from midfield and busting the gut to get up front, because the game could go on like this for, you know, you could play for hours and nobody scored a goal, and really a chance has to be taken by Rangers if they're going to score.
Well, Hatley is certainly the man who has put Hearts to the sword in recent seasons. In fact, Hatley scored no fewer than 7 in the 5 meetings between the sides last season. So if you're a betting man, you'd maybe have a few quid in him today. That's Loudrup. Goff's well forward. That's headed away, though, by Alan McLaren for another corner. Two Rangers. Again, it's Ryan Loudrup to take it. Hatley comes in, but good defending by Craig Levine. It'll nudge away to Mo Johnston. Muir deals with that one well. That's Murray. McLaren steps in though for Hearts. This is Leitch. Trying to switch the play through to John Cahoon. That's a good ball. It's McPherson at sixes and sevens, but David Robertson comes to Rangers' rescue. That's Berry. He takes that one down well, especially with Heatley so close. That's Craig Levine. Robertson. McLaren. Off with plenty of time. And the backward header allowing Gorham to handle. Cam defending.
I think the longer the game goes on like this, I think the happier Tommy McLean's going to be. Because like you said, Hearts are coming in more and more to the game. And Rangers just seem not to be able to break them down.
Nice little first touch by Craig Moore. And that ball takes a deflection for the corner kick, coming off Scott Leach. So a third corner to Rangers in the space of a couple of minutes. But really, they're still to test Henry Smith in the Hearts goal. Well, Goff moves forward. Good shot to Moore. Smith comes for it. Well, having a word there with Craig Levine.
Did well, Henry Smith. Takes a lot of pressure off your defence when your goalkeeper comes and collects a dangerous whipping ball into the box like that. I'm sure Tommy's quite happy with that. Henry's come in to fill Nicky's place at the moment and looked very secure.
Well, Tommy McLean certainly looking very animated below us, but he will not be unhappy with the situation. Still no scoring here at Ibrox. Just over half an hour gone. This is Murray to Craig Moore. Murray again. Touch from Moore into McCall. McPherson. A little bit of a chance there as he found Robertson, because Cahoon almost cut it off. But that's a long ball now from McCall. Robertson trying to find a way through, but across comes Neil Berry. Finding McLaren. Now it's Cahoon. Robertson. McLaren. Good play by Hearts. It's got Leach. Mo Johnson calling for it in a lot of space. Johnson chests it down. It's McLaren. Hearts certainly stringing the passes together. Tosh McKinley's well forward. But, the pass from McLaren, there's too much for him, but some decent passes from the Hearts team there.
Yeah, a good indication of how Hearts are coming back into the game. Super passing movement there, and again, it all began from McLaren playing in that position in between midfield, just in front of his defence, who started out and unfortunately was just a little bit long with his pass to Tosh McKinley.
This is David Robertson to Durant. Trying to get away from the attentions of McLaren. Berry nips in just ahead of Loudrup. Rangers have it again, that's Durant. Sending it to McCall. Ian Ferguson, Craig Moore's a lot of space. It's cut out there. The pass not the best, and it was easily cut out by John Millar. Now it's Hearts on the counter-attack. It's Mo Johnston. To Cahoon. Back out towards Johnston. Murray comes in to make the challenge, but that's good play by McLaren. Johnston. Tosh McKinley comes in support. Play to McLaren. Gets away from Ian Ferguson. This is John Cahoon! And he couldn't quite get the bend in the shot, I think he was trying. And it ended up quite an easy one for Andy Gorham. But superb play by McLaren, who got away from Ian Ferguson, squeezed the ball through to Cahoon. Now it's Rangers on the attack, it's Loudrup showing tremendous pace, Levine's with him, still it's Loudrup. That's behind for the corner kick.
Just when you think it was another a chance for Hearts at one end, Brian Loudrup screaming up the left-hand side. Levine does well, defends well, and it's another corner for Rangers.
So the pace of the game lifting, in comes the corner kick. Breaks to Mo Johnson, who does the right thing, gets it away from the danger area. That's Moore for Rangers to Durant. It's cut out by McLaren. Murray, though, pounces on it for Rangers. This is McPherson looking for the head of Hatley. Goff's up there as well. The keeper's under pressure here. And the handshake between the two players. Henry Smith not intimidated as Hatley come flying in. Goff was there as well.
Only good thing there, I said that Jim McCluskey didn't give a foul against Mark Hatley. It's too often that goalkeepers are...
You're biased.
Well, I am certainly very biased, but there is too often that referees are more than cover up for goalkeepers, and it was a good take by Henry under a lot of pressure from Mark Hatley there.
So they throw in two hearts. Robertson leaving it to Tosh McKinley, trying to go on the outside of Moore. Real battle going on between these two, and again Moore does well. But, that's a bit of a risky one, picked up though by Ian Ferguson. Levine with a bit of time, but Loudrup closes in, almost caught him. Levine seemed to have plenty of time there, but when there's a player like Loudrup about, there's always danger lurking. And it's Goff's header putting, got him under pressure from Cahoon. A little breakdown in communication there, perhaps, between the Rangers skipper and his goalkeeper, and John Cahoon almost pouncing on it.
I think John's lucky, actually. I think he tried to punch out of Andy Gorham's hands. Could have found yourself in the book there. Nevertheless, a good take from Andy Gorham. A little bit slack from Richard Goff, who's back here, though.
So 10 minutes of the first half left here at Ibrox Stadium. Rangers nil, Hearts nil. Throw from Robertson, looking for Hatley. Berry's there though. Corner kick. Things are all from the crowd. Berry certainly defending stoutly.
The last 10-15 minutes he's been absolutely outstanding in the back for Hearts, Neil Berry. And sweeped up almost everything that Rangers have thrown at them.
It's Levine's header. Touch from Robertson. This is McCall to Ferguson. McCall running into the box, looking for the return. It's Ferguson trying the shot. No power. Well, McCall, who had nudged the ball to him, went darting into the penalty area. But, there was no way through for Ferguson to try and get it back to him. It's Moore's header. Played back by Tosh McKinley. Throw in to Rangers. Pity Basil Bolly didn't make it today. It would have been interesting to see Mo Johnson perhaps operating against him, as both played in the French League. And again, was out of play.
I'd love to listen to that conversation, Jerry.
This is Loudrup. Moore. Ferguson under pressure from Leach, but he does well. Nice pass with the outside of the foot to Robertson. In looking for Hatley. We saw Mark Hatley picking up a couple of awards before the game for his goal-scoring feats of last season. 30 goals he scored in 55 games. Missed just two matches last season and very much carried Rangers for long spells, but the goals tended to dry up for him a bit towards the end of the season. He failed to score in the last six games, but this season he struck four times already. This is McPherson for Rangers. Robertson. That's Goff. Through for Durant. Durant trying to play it through towards Murray.
It's going to be very difficult for Rangers today if they are going to break them down. I think a perfect example there, they really should come out and go round the outside, and they're almost playing against a five-man back four when Alan McLaren drops five-man defence when Alan McLaren moves back into it. Very difficult for them to go through the middle.
That's McLaren sending the ball to Leach. That's Berry. Bit short with that one, allowing Ian Ferguson to pounce. Now it's McCall. To McLaren back ahead of Loudrup. Berry to Miller. Ross McKinley. Stumble by Goff. In fact, the referee penalising John Robertson, who pleads his innocence. This is Ian Ferguson. Goff. Durant. Robertson starts a run on the left. Cahoon goes with him. Good play by Robertson. And again, it's that man Berry sliding in. Excellent play though by Robertson, getting away from Cahoon.
This is exactly what I said about going up round the outside, and not only the fact that about taking a chance, the willingness of Robertson on the outside almost created a goal opportunity for Rangers.
And that one flashing right across the face of goal, coming off the head of John Miller. Certainly a heart-stopping moment, if you pardon the pun.
I'm not even going to make comment on that.
So that's Ian Durant coming across to this near side to take the corner for Rangers. McPherson has moved forward with Goff. He plays there also. That's Ian Ferguson's header. Well, Ian Ferguson still waiting to open his account for the season. Getting in the header there, but over the top.
I think that's another reason why possibly Rangers have struggled over the last little bit there with Ian Ferguson. You know, you look for your midfield players to get X amount of goals in the season, and so far, you know, the midfield have struggled to actually hit the target.
So just under 5 minutes of the first half left here at Ibrox Stadium in this Premier Division match. It's Rangers nil, Hearts nil. Levine plays it to McLaren. It's McKinley. Walked by Murray. Neil Murray, who broke into the Rangers team a couple of years ago during the Champions League run. This is his third start of the season today. That ball's out of play. So it's Rangers' throw. Ross McKinley just failing to keep that one in. That's McCall for Rangers. To Ferguson. Chested down by Robertson. Again, Cahoon goes back with him. And Cahoon blocks him. This is McPherson. It's Robertson again. Easily dealt with by McLaren. Good solid clearance. This is Goff. The Rangers player on the ground, David Robertson, just outside the Hearts penalty area. He took a knock there, obviously, when he was challenged by Cahoon. And the ball goes out of play now, which will allow some treatment for the Rangers fullback, who's played well in this first half, getting forward at every opportunity.
Never actually saw, Jerry, what happened there, but they said he has had a good first half. He's certainly prepared, in the last 10, 15 minutes, he's certainly prepared to get forward and get crosses into the box of Rangers. And they really don't want a player of David Robertson to get injured and upset the formation.
Well, there's a player who misses very few games. Joined Rangers back in 1991 from Aberdeen. It went to a tribunal who valued him at £970,000. A player of tremendous pace. So, happily for him and for Rangers, he's back to his feet. I think it was a clash with John Cahoon that led to it. He was moving forward. No, in fact, it was Gary Locke who had caught him. McCall trying to battle his way through. Referee steps in and awards a free kick to Rangers. So just under 2 minutes of the first half left. This is Durant. McCall. Durant again. Looking for Hatley. Henry Smith taking that ball at the second attempt.
I think of the two managers, Jerry, I think Tony McLean will be the happiest, or the happier of the two. Walter, I think I'll be concerned with the amount of actual chances they have made throughout the first half, although they were certainly well on top in the first 15 minutes. But I think Rangers have to just inject that little bit extra. I mean, they are playing at home, they've got to please their fans, and if they're going to break down this Hearts defence, they've got to have players that's going to take a chance.
Walter Smith hasn't picked him down to the dugout as Mo Johnson comes forward, and that's Ian Ferguson, who slams a ball out of play, just nipping it away from Miller. John Miller, who was well forward. Throw in to Hearts as we go into the final minutes, plus some injury time to be added on by Jim McCluskey, the referee. It's Gary Locke who's come forward. Now it's Tosh McKinley, and he's impeded by Neil Murray. And it's a free kick to Hearts. And what a time this would be to nip a goal right on half time. Again, Tosh McKinley trying to get forward, and again winning a free kick, this time Murray the culprit. So Hearts have pushed Levine forward, McLaren's up there, who's also very good in the air. David McPherson watching Levine closely. It's Tosh McKinley with his left foot. It's Robertson who got it away. Now it's Loudrup to Durant. Loudrup running ahead of him. Hearts getting plenty of players back. Loudrup as we move into injury time. Still no scoring here. It's Robertson, and Locke is challenged by McPherson. Good challenge too. Gary Locke breaking forward. This is Goff for Rangers. It's Durant. Play through now, looking for Loudrup. Henry Smith responds quickly, though. Racing from his line.
Did well there, Henry Smith. Plays as a sweeper. Follows out as far as he possibly could. Sweeps up the trouble for Hearts.
Archie Knox just below us with Walter Smith shouting instructions to other players. Now well into injury time in this first half as Tosh McKinley comes forward. Now it's Miller. It's McKinley again, being carefully watched by Ferguson. Takes a return from Robertson. Good linking play between the two Hearts players, but the cross right into the arms of Andy Gorham. It's an excellent play by Tosh McKinley.
Yeah, he really does look to get forward a lot, Tosh McKinley, every opportunity that he can. Although, unfortunately, there's no one making the near post run, although, to be fair, the cross wasn't a good one, it was far too close to Andy Gorham. But again, signs that Hearts have come right back into the game, Jerry, and, you know, that everything good for them is coming up this left-hand side with Tosh McKinley.
David McPherson has taken a bit of a knock. And he's being helped from the field. That's 2 minutes of injury time played. And this is Neil Murray for Rangers as the half-time whistle sounds. Well, the first half in which Rangers began well, pressured Hearts quite a bit without getting any real shots in on Henry Smith. Neither goalkeeper busy, but Hearts certainly coming more and more into the game as it went on. A half-time score here at Ibrox, Rangers 0, Hearts 0.
Yes, as Jerry says, Rangers 0, Hearts 0. We'll get the first half thoughts of David Cooper and Charlie Nicholas right after this break. We'll see you then.
Work saves Hearts, no! It's gone in at last. And it's big Dave Mitchell who does it.
Dave Mitchell, the Australian international striker, scoring in a 2-0 win for Rangers from October 1983. Charlie, at Ibrox this afternoon, well, it's not exactly thrill a minute, is it?
No, it's certainly not. It's a bit of a drab game so far. Very, very nervous, both teams, I think, worried about mistakes. I said this earlier about Rangers players being worried about their support, and you can see it, they're very, very edgy. Hearts are just sitting and annoying them, upsetting them, and they've come into the game a little bit, but not really much happened in the game, to be honest.
There was a fear, David, it would be like this because of previous matches.
Yeah, it's very, very nervy. You can see that in both teams. Wee Tommy will be the happiest at this moment in time of the two managers. Mm. I think they're playing it very tight. Alan McLaren is playing in front of the back four just to deny the space for the midfielders to run into. And actually, in the last 10 minutes of the match, Hearts have begun to break up the park and get the odd chance. So a lot to concern Walter Smith.
Sure. Loudrup might make the difference, and we've seen evidence of him in the first half, Charlie. A good run from him early on, and Neil Murray with a shot.
He gets on Neil Berry. I don't know why Neil Berry's out there, because he skins him here. He needs to hit the target. He doesn't. But if they leave Neil Berry with Loudrup, he'll cause havoc. He's not the type of player, Berry, to do much with Loudrup.
He could turn it for Rangers, Loudrup, I think, Davey. And again, a good cross from him. John Miller did well to get the ball away from Hakeley.
Yeah, certainly. But Loudrup looks the one who could maybe change it if anyone could in the Rangers side at the moment. That was a great ball in with his right foot. And Mark Hakeley was nearly on the end of it, but the boy Miller done superb there.
Because if Hakeley, Hakeley lethal in a situation like that normally, isn't he? Charlie, what about Hearts? Mo Johnson at the other end, he did quite well, but he ended up hitting the side netting. But what do you make of him?
He's been very busy, Mo. He's had a couple of efforts at goal. Pretty disappointing, to be honest. He's in and about it again here. He's been very lively, and I think he's playing just a little bit in the wide left area, and he's getting a bit more room. But he's been the liveliest Hearts forward there.
And Hearts a bit more prominent towards the end of the first half there, David. John Cahoon went close.
Yeah, certainly. Last 10 minutes, they have come into it. Mo Johnson's one of these players that if you leave him for 89 minutes, he could score in the 90th minute. That's the kind of player. John Cahoon, with his strong running, is also causing a few problems now. He had a shot there, but it was straight in the Andy Gorham's body. But he's another dangerous player for Hearts.
We need a goal from somewhere, Charlie. Do you think it'll happen,
The way it's looking just now, no, to be honest. But, the longer the game goes, Hearts will be that bit more excited about maybe going and getting the win.
Yes, indeed. OK, well, time for another break there. The second half, live from Ibrox in a couple of minutes. Rangers Hearts. Morris Johnson now of Hearts, then of Rangers, scoring the only goal of the game in September 1989. Right now at Ibrox, it's Rangers 0, Hearts 0. Let's go back there now and rejoin Gerry.
Welcome back, everyone, to Ibrox Stadium. The second half gets underway, and Rangers have made a change. McPherson, who was injured just before half-time, has gone off, and on has come Gordon Jury, who's operating out on the right-hand side. Rangers have had to recast things a bit at the back. Neil Murray has gone to right back, and Craig Moore has gone in alongside Richard Goff in central defence, with David Robertson still operating in the left back role. So this is Ian Ferguson. A touch from Robertson, looking for Hakeley. It's away though by Berry. Well, Hearts this afternoon have Alan Johnson and Graham Hogg on the bench. Rangers' other substitute is Duncan Ferguson.
Just on the change, I think it's a positive move, although forced upon Walter Smith. I think Gordon Jury will certainly look to get a lot further forward more often than maybe Neil Murray would in midfield, and I think Neil will be more at ease playing in a familiar role at right back.
And perhaps best chance falling to Rangers in the first half fell to Murray. If it fallen to a striker, it might have hit the net. But, it's all very well in hindsight. Murray, who's taking this kick from Andy Gorham. Returned by John Miller. And this is Robertson. It's through now to Moore. Ian Ferguson. Durant's wide left. This is Durant. Ball's out of play. But we're just out. Perhaps a pass hit with just a little too much strength, and he was always toiling to get it. He'd certainly found himself a bit of space, Ian Durant. Berry trying to clear the ball, breaks away there to Hatley. Now it's Cahoon for Hearts. Robertson. Steps McLaren. Cahoon. And Ferguson has collapsed just in front of the Rangers dugout. Still play goes on. This is Mo Johnston. In comes Miller. Miller stepping away from Jury. Trying to get away from Murray. And it's Murray who gets it away. It was Craig Moore who made the initial challenge, which was an important one for Rangers. Well, Ian Ferguson is back in his feet as Gordon Jury goes in a great run. Trying to win his pace. And the referee waved away the claims for a free kick as he was challenged by Neil Berry. Mr. McCluskey well up with the play, waving away the claims.
It's a good decision by John McCluskey. I think Gordon had just put the ball too far in front of himself and was losing possession. And Moore used his body more than anything to bump into Neil Berry. There was absolutely nothing in it.
Well, this is Durant. Finding Laudrup. Laudrup stepping away from Locke. It was John Miller who headed the ball out of the danger area.
Even though Gordon Jury made a meal of that one, I think already signs clear to see that exactly what I meant of certainly a little bit more at ease going forward.
A mistake by Berry, and it's Laudrup trying to get through. Well, Laudrup feels he was impeded, but again Jim McCluskey just looks and shakes his head. This time a free kick was awarded, but it's to Hearts for the challenge by Richard Goff on John Robertson.
Again, Jim McCluskey right over the play. He's absolutely correct in his decision. Richard can't believe it. John Robertson actually almost skinned Richard there, and Richard definitely held him back. He cannot complain about that.
Well, Jim McCluskey, highly rated by his fellow referees. And like every decision, bang on. This is Laudrup to Durant. Ian Ferguson's going in a run on the far side of the field. Still it's Durant. Hearts have had time to get players back, and Durant overhitting that pass as he tried to pick out Ian Ferguson.
Now, you want Ian to have a lot of touches in midfield and create something, but I think in that, certainly that instance, an early ball to Ian Ferguson who was way out in the clear would have been more beneficial to Rangers.
Three awards, the free kick to Rangers. Scott Leach getting in the way of Ian Ferguson, so it's Durant to take it. Richard Goff moves forward to the edge of the area. There he is, climbing, getting the touch. It's easily taken in the end by Henry Smith.
Good header from Richard Goff. It's kind of place that Alistair McCoy to score most of his goal with Rangers prowling around the front of the goalkeeper like that. Maybe that's just exactly what Rangers are missing at the moment.
And it's 5 minutes of the second half gone here at Ibrox Stadium. Rangers nil, Hearts nil. It's Moore playing it through, looking for Laudrup. Berry climbs well up. This is McLaren for Hearts to Cahoon. Taken a bit late by Laudrup. Free kick to Hearts.
Bit of a collector's item there, Brian actually tackling somebody. Actually, John does really well. Takes Brian on. Okay, Brian actually does just catch his right foot. A little bit of a twist. John should be all right, though. Not something you'll see Brian doing off a lot. He's tackling.
John Cahoon, who started off his career at Stirling Albion, the spell at Celtic. First time round with Hearts, and down south to Millwall and Sunderland before moving back to Tynecastle. He was in fact in the Hearts team which came so close to winning the championship in 1986. They were picked on the final day by Celtic. So he has recovered, and it's Gary Locke who swings in the free kick. Mo Johnson's on the far side. It's Jury providing the cover. It breaks away there to Tosh McKinley. And Goff gets it near his touch, and that's away by David Robertson for Hatley to chase. Levine's with him. And Levine gets in just ahead of the Rangers striker. That's a throw-in, indicates the referee. It's a touch from Loudrup now for Rangers, chested down by Jury. It's Murray in support. Hyman again in towards Hatley. It's away by Leach. Touch from Ian Ferguson. Loudrup way out on the right-hand side again. He certainly covers a lot of ground, and he's unceremoniously taken out of the play by Tosh McKinley. The referee calling over the Hearts defender.
Yeah, I think Tosh, in his anxiousness to get the ball, certainly caught Ryan a little bit late with his left foot coming through. Really can't complain about going in the referee's book there.
And the yellow card comes out. Loudrup, meanwhile, is back on his feet. So a difficult second half looming for Tosh McKinley. And there's Goff again getting in the header, but he's looking for some support inside the box. He's clearly unhappy. That's the second time in the space of a few minutes he's got his head to the ball, not got down into an area, but there's been no one moving in to take advantage.
He's absolutely right, Jerry. I mean, he's coming forward onto a dead ball situation. He's got his head onto it. He's done his job right, and there's no support for him. He's every right to be to complain to his fellow compatriots that there's no one there.
Now, John Robertson penalised for his challenge on Craig Moore. Crowd getting right behind the team. Hearts with a rather hot here this afternoon. They had been allocated the lower tier of the room loan stand. They couldn't fill that bond. Some Rangers fans have been allocated those spaces. This is Jury. Good chest control. Finding Ian Ferguson. This is Murray. Ferguson again. McCall. Loudrup. Switch back to the left. Nice turn by David Robertson. The chance on for Jury. Tosh McKinley did just enough to block Jury. A great play by David Robertson. A lovely turn there, sweeping in the cross. And Jury trying to get a good contact with it.
Yeah, already a good awareness from Brian Loudrup. Super turn by David Robertson. Great ball into the middle, unfortunately, just no Rangers player can get it. It's well defended in the end by Hearts, but again, already the crowd getting a little bit more behind Rangers now in the start of the second half, and they're starting to look a bit more like the team that won the league last year.
Well, we're 10 minutes into the second half, still no scoring here at Ibrox Stadium in this Premier Division match between Rangers and Hearts in the Bells League Championship. Nice turn by Loudrup, getting away from Berry. Gary Locke comes across to provide some cover, and it's Craig Levine who steps in. It's aimed out towards Cahoon, but Robertson nipped in. McCall digs in well against Leach, and it's Ian Ferguson. Murray's breaking in the right. Robertson's coming back to try and mark him, but the effort right across the face of the six-yard area, and behind for the goal kick from Neil Murray.
I think it could be a blessing in disguise, nothing against Big David, actually he took the knock, and I think Neil Murray's a lot happier supporting from there rather than going forward, and it seems to be a completely better shape to the Rangers team.
This is Murray, Ferguson, Durant. Now it's Jury, taking on Tosh McKinley. And Berry gets in there just ahead of Hatley. Now it's Durant again, looking for McCall. Well, the header across the six-yard area, looking for Hatley, but it drifted into the hands of Smith. There's McCall still battling away with John Cahoon. Cahoon doing well against three Rangers players, just keeping possession. And that ball forward from Locke is cleared by David Robertson. This is John Robertson. It's supported by Locke, but Ian Ferguson doing some sterling defensive work in a very tight situation. It almost goes wrong for him, but he gets a second bite. Ball come off Miller to Durant. He's got Jury away to the right. He's got Loudrup ahead of him. Hadley's in the middle. He decided to try and barge his way through, but too many Hearts players around them.
I think he made the decision as soon as he picked the ball up, he was going to go in a solo there. And he had so many options on. The Rangers get the game by the scruff of the neck at the moment. Hearts doing well to weather this storm.
And McCall taking his eye off the ball. He was planning his next touch before he took the first one. And Hearts have possession. This is McLaren. Robertson. Picked up by Leach. He tries to just knock that one over Gorham. Not a bad effort from the former Dunfermline player.
It's a great effort here. Tried to catch Andy Gorham completely unawares, and it wasn't that far away. That would have certainly silenced this crowd had that gone in. Good first touch, gives himself a couple of yards opportunity and almost hit the target.
This is Loudrup for Rangers. Through for Hadley, it's a good ball, it's Hadley past the goalkeeper, it's a penalty! Well, this will be interesting now to see if Mr. McCluskey puts the Hearts goalkeeper, Hadley, right through. And Mr. McCluskey immediately pointing in towards the penalty spot.
Great ball through from Brian Loudrup, absolutely superb, pin perfect. Big Mark just got a touch on it and Henry just took the legs from Big Mark.
Well, the referee taking no action against the Hearts goalkeeper. So the chance for a breakthrough for Rangers. Hadley has a good record from the spot. Can he score his fifth of the season? He can! Rangers 1, Hearts 0. 59 minutes gone, and Rangers break the deadlock. And there's great relief all around Ibrox Stadium. Perfect strike by Hadley right into the corner.
Good confidence strike by Mark Hadley from the spot there. Really gave Henry Smith no chance. Mark will be well pleased with that. And really, it's no more than deserved for the start they have certainly made in the second half, Rangers, even though it did come to the penalty spot. And I believe they'll go on and score another couple of goals now. Hearts are really on the rack.
This is Gary Locke under pressure from Durant. Ball still in play. Given away by Durant. Toss McKinley, but he's under pressure from Gordon Jury. Rangers with their tails up now.
I think not only Jerry with Rangers getting their tails up now, I think it's just exactly what the game needed. And hopefully it'll spur Hearts into something a little bit more special for their own fans.
This is McLaren. Good play by McLaren. Loudrup sticking with him all the way. McLaren does really well in a very tight situation. This is Miller, switching the play to Cahoon. Now can Hearts respond here? Well, it's a poor cross from Cahoon. Knocked away by Ian Ferguson, now it's Durant trying to pick out Hadley. It's blocked by Berry. Robertson digs in for Rangers, forward comes Cahoon. Good skills by Cahoon, stepping away there from Durant, sending it through, the chance on for Mo Johnson, but the flag had gone up on the near side. And the referee signals to the linesman that he saw the flag go up.
Good surging run from John Cahoon there. Morris Johnson just come in a little bit too late. Good decision by the linesman, he certainly was offside there.
It's Hadley's header, touch from Tosh McKinley, now it's Levine. The little gap opens up for John Miller. Play by McLaren to Cahoon. Rangers certainly giving up plenty of the pitch in that area. It's played through now to John Robertson. It's Cahoon getting forward, clipping it through, and it's clawed away by Andy Gorham. The Rangers conceding a lot of territory there. Great gap opening up in the midfield area and allowing Hearts to get the ball deep into Rangers territory, and it was Gorham who clawed it away for the corner.
Andy Gorham with a fingertip save. The John Cahoon does really well, does superb, just manages to keep the ball in play. Andy Gorham claws it away. Good things for Hearts at the moment. They're coming back in after losing the bad penalty.
It's a toss by McKinley hitting the in-swinger with the left foot. It's away by Gorham, picked up by Loudrup. This could be interesting. There's three breaking against two here. It's played through now for Jury and Durant. It's Gordon Jury for Rangers, trying to feed it through to Durant. And he just can't make it. What a break forward that was by Rangers, pouring forward. Loudrup with both Durant and Jury. Jury stumbling at the vital moment, and here come Hearts. It's Miller to Mo Johnston. This is McLaren again. John Cahoon's got a bit of space. Robertson comes to meet him. Swinging it to the far side, but McCall trying to take that down in his chest and send it through to Jury. He takes the return. Giving it away, but he recovers, has to concede the corner kick up. The Rangers were knocking the ball a bit with confidence, but the Rangers defender getting himself into an unnecessary piece of pressure. And now Craig Levein moves into the area. Hatley goes with him. That's behind for a goal kick. Well, a tremendous breakout by Rangers just a few moments ago. Loudrup it was who got everything going. And that's something Hearts will have to look out for as they chase the game now, trying to get themselves back on level terms. This is Levein. Meanwhile, Duncan Ferguson, who's going out to warm up on the touchline, down towards the Copeland Road stand. A £4 million man. He's got four goals to his credit this season, and already his international experience, and his 23rd birthday not coming up till December, so still plenty of time for him to make his mark here with Rangers. Played through by Robertson, looking for Hatley. Levein's with him. It's Hearts ball. Well, Craig Levein was under pressure from Hatley in the early stages of the game. A player of great pace. He did take a knock, in fairness to him, in midweek playing in Finland, and they had to have a fitness test before this game today. This little touch by Ian Ferguson. This is Murray. Gordon Jury. Moore. Murray again. And McCall takes charge of the situation. Plays it through to Loudrup. It's Loudrup against Locke. Going in the outside defender. Good cross. Away by Tosh McKinley. It's picked up by Gordon Jury. That's a goal kick, Andy kicks the linesman. But again, Loudrup swinging in, a good cross, and Rangers will want to see more of that in this second half.
Yeah, a real teaser from Brian Loudrup, right to the back post there. Mark Hatley, a little bit too far in this time, just too much for Gordon Jury to get right round the back.
Well, Hearts really do have a rather miserable record against Rangers. It's more than 4 years now. In the space of 4 years, I should say, just one victory. And then last season, taking only 2 points out of a possible eight, and also going out of the Scottish Cup to Rangers. So they have a big battle in their hands in the second half. It's a trail by 1-0 with 66 minutes gone. Moore playing it to Murray. Miller climbs above Hatley. Mo Johnston loses out to Ian Ferguson. Through now for Hatley. again. Rangers don't have many players forward. And that looked like handball by Jury. So the throw-in has been awarded. Two Hearts. So Johnson playing it to John Miller. Robertson turning away from Goff. John Robertson, tremendous scoring record for Hearts. He celebrates his 30th birthday next month. Here he is again. Tosh McKinley trying to get forward. He's fouled by Jury. It's quickly taken. Tosh McKinley takes the return from Robertson. Goes the outside of Murray. That's good play by the fullback. And he's got the corner kick. Well, the Rangers fans in the Copeland Road stand howling.
5,000 referees.
They seem to think that Tosh McKinley stumbled. He certainly tried to move inside and then went on the outside of the defender, but it's a corner kick. It's well headed away by David Robertson. Here's Loudrop. Gets away from Berry. He needs some support here. Jury's coming through the middle, so too is Hitley. Again, Rangers very slow to respond. Get players forward. Great break again by Loudrop, but no one going in support. They had to hold things up again. This is Robertson. And it goes now to John Robertson of Hearts. That's a rather hopeful ball, which is given away. That's McCall to Jury, who's switched over now to the left-hand side. That comes off Berry. Hanging away by Miller, returned by Goff. This is McCall. Durant's calling for it. This is Durant. Ferguson goes in a powerful run and provides a shot. Not a bad effort. The Rangers will want to see more of that from this man too.
Really well-weighted pass here from Ian Durant. CZ and Ferguson on the move. Fergie does well to hit the target. Good save by Henry Smith.
Nicely weighted and well taken by the goalkeeper. Switch of play by McLaren to Cahoon. Closed down by Durant. Supported by Locke. Takes a return. Trying to find Mo Johnson. This is Miller. It's charged down though by Ian Ferguson. Now it's Scott Leach. And he's flattened out as McCall come in and Moore challenged. This could be a testing moment for Andy Gorham in the Rangers defence. Well, Andy Gorham, just a one shutout this season in 6 games for Rangers, although he did have a shutout in Finland during the week where he won his 30th cap. And Walter Smith's first signing. So he organises the defensive wall, and they want to do it better than they did in the game against Celtic. No doubt lessons have been learned from that. It's Miller who strikes it. No real problem in the end for Andy Gorham, as the former Blackburn player struck the ball.
Plenty of power on the shot, but you know, it's never really going to trouble Andy Gorham, that one. Been quite impressed the way Craig Moore has fitted in beside Richard Goff. He's been quite at ease rather than playing it right back. That's a big plus for Rangers.
Ian Durant digging in hard. And now it's McCall finding Loudrop. Hitley peels away from these markers. Comes in from the far post. Broke on the left, Hitler peeled away from his markers, away out to the right-hand side of the penalty area, then began the charge forward as the cross was provided. So after 71 minutes, Matt Hitler gets his second of the match. It's Rangers 2, Hearts 0.
It's a great ball from Brian Loudrop. It's gone to the same place where Mark Sykes had been caught a little bit too far forward. Held his run this time, timed it to perfection, comes in at the back post. Great goal. Great goal. It's a goal scorer's goal. It's a super ball in.
And great movement by Heatley there.
Yeah, superb. I mean, if he knows Brian Lauder's going to deliver such a quality cross like that, he can wait, time he's run, come in at the back post, and Mark Heatley will score another 30 goals this season if Brian delivers some balls like that in the box. Superb. Well on top now, Rangers.
This is Robertson. That's Goff. Robertson again. Chested down by Heatley. Well, he hit something like 8 doubles last season, didn't manage a hat-trick. In fact, it's something I know he'd dearly love to do for Rangers, what an opportunity he has this afternoon. Well, he did say, when he was speaking to Jim Delahunt before the game, that he'd like to pick up the Man of the Match award to add to the two. He got the 4 kick-off. I would think it's a fair bet he'll do that.
Just round it off nicely with a hat-trick, Jerry, would be lovely.
I think he'll need an escort home tonight.
Absolutely. I think he'll be more pleased with the 3 points, so I think it's very important that Rangers got the win today. I'm not saying, you know, the game but not by far finished yet, but they're certainly looking on target for it.
So you can actually sense the confidence surging through this Rangers team for the first time in quite a while. This is Laudrup. That's Hearts in possession through John Cahoon. Long one for Robertson to chase. Well, got him driving it against Richard Goff. He's all over the place here. But he responds well. Now that brings a huge cheer from the Rangers fans. He was all over the place for a moment, but he had the presence of mind when it mattered. Nice little backfield flip from Andy Gorham.
Believe me, Jerry, I'll have the biggest smell in Ibrox after that coming off. No doubt I'll get some stick in the dressing room. But like you say, you know, when the confidence is up and the tail's up, you're 2-0 in front, those little things sometimes come off for you.
This is Laudrup again, showing great pace, getting away from Locke. Berry comes across, but a stumble at the vital moment. Young Gary Locke, because he's worked it out for him, and Laudrup switches over to that area of the field, showing a great burst of pace, but is losing his footing. Neil Berry had to come across as well to provide some cover. He's certainly making a major contribution in this second half as Ryan Laudrup. It's 75 minutes gone now. Rangers leading Hearts by 2-0, both from Mark Heatley. The penalty after 59 minutes and a superb finish after 71. Here come Rangers again. It's played out to Laudrup. Cahoon goes back to provide some cover. This is Durant. Looking for Gordon Jury. It's headed down though by Levine. This is McLaren. That's Robertson. Just miscuing that one as he tried to pick out John Cahoon. And the Rangers have the throw in.
I think I actually saw John out the side of his eye making a forward run and just couldn't get his body round the ball to play it in.
So Hearts needing to find something very quickly here. They're looking just a bit dispirited at the moment. Come into this match in bottom place in the Premier Division. It looks like being a long, hard season for Tommy McLean and his men. This is Durant for Rangers. Call Durant again. Play through by Goff. Laudrup using the pace of Robertson. This could be an excellent partnership. That's a good cross. It's Jury. It's 3. Great play again by Rangers. Laudrup sending the ball through to Robertson. This tremendous pace, carrying him away from the defenders. A great cross. And Gordon Jury there to make it 3-0 to Rangers.
Yeah, good interplay by Brian Laudrup and Robertson. Great deep ball. Oh, I thought it was going to come to Mark Heatley. A little bit of insurance. Gordon Jury in behind him. And he won't get an easier goal than that, Gordon Jury. Again, I said that they were forced to make the change and they did. And I honestly think
It worked out well for them.
The Rangers making a change, and Loubert leaving the field to tremendous applause. And on comes Duncan Ferguson. Well, Loudrup goes into the Rangers dugout to much applause, and on comes Duncan Ferguson. So Loudrup, having made his contribution, heads off to the dressing room.
Certainly earned his money today, Jerry. You know, he has made the difference in this second half. Carved our way out, and Rangers are now cruising to 3 points.
Here come Hearts through Tosh McKinley, gets in a decent cross, Oram knocked it away. It's behind for the goal kick. Well, the official attendance this afternoon, 41,041. The crowds at Ibrox this season, the opening day against Motherwell was 43,700, against Ike Athens, 44,500. And the largest crowd so far against Celtic, 45,466. So some activity now in the Hearts bench below us. It looks as though it'll be a double substitution. Alan Johnson and Graham Hogg taking off the tracksuits. But it looks now too little, too late. The game well beyond Hearts. But even in terms of goal difference, they'll work to pull something back. That was Craig Moore nipping in just ahead of Mo Johnston.
I don't even think it's the last throw of the dice for Tommy McLean. I think he's just making a change. The simple reason he's not happy the way things have went in the second half.
Levine looking that ball back to Smith, and not the best of pass backs, and goalkeeper having to send the ball out of play. But those substitutions about to happen now. So John Robertson leaving the field, so too is Locke. Well, the game going on was utter confusion down there. So Robertson still on the field, comes back into play. This is Locke. Robertson. Through by Locke. Touch from Richard Goff. This is Ian Ferguson. And the offside flag is up against Duncan Ferguson, so those substitutions can now take place.
Double substitution for Harvard Midlothian. Off comes number two.
So Locke and Robertson leave the field, and on come Alan Johnson and Graham Hogg. Alan Johnson, who will be 21 in December, signed 4 years ago from the Tynecastle Boys Club. And Hogg and Levine, well, they've met already this season in rather controversial circumstances. This is John Miller. Johnson losing out to Ian Ferguson. That's Stuart McCall getting the early ball, trying to sweep it wider left for Duncan Ferguson. Go through by McLaren. This is Miller. He's got Cahoon to his right. Just 9 minutes left, and the scoreboard tells the story. Rangers 3, Hearts 0. Two from Hatley, one from Dury. It's all about consolation for Hearts now. And making their goal difference respectable, which could be rather vital in what's going to be a tough season for them. Again, it all goes sour for Hearts. Rangers have the throw. Send it Duncan Ferguson. Levine's in there. So too is Berry. Ian Ferguson. Holding off Alan Johnson. And it's Moore.
Robertson plays it through to Headley. Ferguson, Robertson. Touch from Durant. Durant again. So running right into McLaren. Now it's Scott Leach. John Miller. Mo Johnson, but the flag up immediately. Not the happiest of afternoons for your pal out there, Alan.
No, he's, I don't know what he said to the linesman there. I'm not even going to repeat it. But you're right, you know, it's been very difficult for him. Rangers have been so much in top in the second half, and I think it's a little bit frustrating, to say the least.
I think money has to be found for Tommy McLean very quickly.
Well, yeah, I think, I mean, they're going to have to make something available to him because, you know, they're wallowing at the bottom of the league and it's not really where you would expect Hearts to be. And if he's not been given some sort of support, you know, I think they could struggle this year.
Ian Ferguson, McCall, Durant, still McCall, glove running, side, and into the side netting. Well, what a chance that was for Duncan Ferguson. He was well onside as the ball was played through by McCall. Defence got absolutely flat, but he drove the ball into the side netting. Hatley was lurking there too.
Defence all at sixes and sevens here. I mean, you really... You expect Big Duncan maybe to score there. Nisi at least hit the target. Super ball through from Stuart McCall, but I think really they're winning the game so easy now. I think if it had been something on that, I think Big Duncan would have scored.
So just under 6 minutes left. Rangers leading by 3-0. Two from Hatley, one from the penalty spot, and Gordon Jury making it 3 after 76 minutes. That's a free kick to Hearts. This is Miller. Alan Johnson calling for it. There he is. Well challenged though by Stuart McCall. Now it's Jury. Laid off by Durant. This is McCall. Durant again to Ferguson. Robertson full of running. Well spotted there by Ian Ferguson. Well, he tries to, I think, float that one over the goalkeeper. Not Hatley. Is furious because there was a chance of a hat-trick. Hatley not a happy man there.
Every right to be. Honestly, I don't think he actually tried to chip the goalkeeper. I think he actually did try to play it into Mark's area and completely miscued. Mark's angry more than anything. A great run from him. The whole move from Rangers was superb, but honestly, I think he was trying to clip it in for Big Mark there and just a complete miscue.
Well, if he was, it certainly wasn't a miscue. No.
We'll allow him that. There's 3-0
on. Nice, and a fine game. A lot of excellent running by the fullback. So just under 5 minutes left now as Graham Hogg gets the touch. It's Moore who's had a superb game. And that'll maybe save Mr. Murray a couple of million in the years to come if he keeps making the progress he's making as a defender. Here come Hearts. It's Cahoon to John Miller. Looking for Mo Johnston. But Ian Ferguson sweeps them all high into there, and that's a corner to Hearts.
I think of all the play that Rangers have had today, honestly, I think he has impressed me the most. You know, he started at right back, he came in, and, you know, obviously had to fill in the middle, and he's looked not out of place whatsoever. He's got good pace, defends really well, and he's been one of the biggest pluses for Rangers this afternoon. He really has done well.
So Ian Ferguson requiring some treatment. Another player who's got through a power of work this afternoon. Certainly wasn't easy for Rangers in the first half. His heart shut down the midfield area, but Ian Ferguson and Stuart McCall battling on, and eventually the breakthrough coming in this second half. So Ferguson okay, and the match will restart with a corner kick to Hearts. Again, it will be the in-swinger from the left foot of Tosh McKinley. This is Berry. Cahoon. Hatley back doing some defending. A bit slack with the pass up. It's Miller now for Hearts. Out to Mo Johnston. Running by Johnston. And Hearts grab a consolation goal here. Well, McCall knocks it away from the penalty area. Then it's Tosh McKinley. And McLaren losing out to Ian Ferguson. Now it's Jury. Duncan Ferguson's in a bit of space. Hatley's in the middle, so too is Jury. It's played into the feet of Hatley, but Levine is there for Hearts. That's Alan McLaren. I wonder if this result today will hasten his departure in the hope that some monies can be spread about. And it could well be that he comes here to Ibrox, even though Celtic have made a bid for him. So just under 2 minutes left now. Rangers leading by 3-0. The referee stepping in and awarding a free kick to Hearts, just in a line with the Rangers penalty area.
I don't honestly think that it's that Hearts have played terribly badly. I really think it's just been, you know, they haven't, when they've got the ball forward, they haven't got bodies into the box or support, and because of that, they haven't made many chances.
It's a header from Hogg, away by Ian Ferguson. It's Berry, McLaren. Tosh McKinley takes a return from Mo Johnston. They certainly worked very hard, Tosh McKinley. Still he battles away. Good cross as well. And Alan Johnson getting in the header. Superb play again by Tosh McKinley. He's put a lot of work into his game this afternoon for very little return.
He has done. He's done very well, Tosh McKinley. Again, he's at his most happiest when he is going forward, taking on defenders. But it's a great ball in there. And unfortunately for Hearts, Alan Johnson can't get his header on target. But really, it's been not a great deal from Hearts in the second half. And you can count the amount of chances they've had on one hand, Jerry. And you know, if you're going to do that, then you ain't going to win games.
We're inside the final minute. Just how much will this mean to Rangers, this second half performance?
Oh, well, I think what I said in the first half was a kind of ghostly atmosphere, which it certainly was. And I think, you know, they had to produce something to get the fans behind them. And, you know, they really deserve a pat in the back. It's not easy when you've got fans waiting for something to happen. In the second half, they've been, you know, back to their best and giving their fans something to cheer about. You know, that's what you've got to do at home. You've got to make chances. And they've done that, and they've taken three of them well.
So we're well inside the final minute of the game, and Hearts' miserable record against Rangers continues. It's now 16 games since the last registered a win against the Ibrox club. So we're into injury time. This is Robertson. Durant. Looking for Hatley. Well, it looks as though the hat-trick is going to elude the big man again. It's clipped through by Levine. Good solid challenge by Goff, but it breaks away to Alan Johnson. He's looking for Mo Johnson. And Murray's back there, though. That's behind for the goal kick.
I'm sure the Rangers fans wouldn't mind if Morris scored a consolation goal near the end, Joe. Tongue in cheek, he says.
I'll tell you, one man who's bursting to get back into this Rangers team is Ali McCoist, who's been sitting in 299 first-team goals for Rangers for about 11 matches now. He's getting close to fitness again, of course, when he's available. Well, the real competition for places up front. Duncan Ferguson, who's out there battling with Mark Hatley, and Gordon Jury there as well. So maybe Rangers turning in a bit of a corner today. I'm sure Walter Smith will be cautious after the match, but he'll be delighted to have ended this dismal run of three straight home defeats, which cost Rangers a place in the European Champions League and the Coca-Cola Cup. So he kicked against Gordon Jury. Mo Johnston. McLaren motoring forward, but again that young man Craig Lewer as well. And applause rings around the stadium. Took a little bit of a stumble, but he's back on his feet. As Levine swings the ball in 2 minutes now of injury time played. Mo Johnston almost getting an end of that one, but Richard Goff nipping in just ahead of him. This is Levine back to Berry. He had to remain calm there with Duncan Ferguson and Mark Cately running through. And Henry Smith remaining calm also. It's been followed by Berry. And it's Moore again climbing well, but the ball picked up by Alan McLaren. This is Tosh McKinley. There goes the final whistle. The applause rings all around Ibrox Stadium, and Rangers bring a dismal one to an end. Warm handshakes all round. Mark Cately there with two splendid goals. The first after 59 minutes from the penalty spot. The second coming in 71 minutes, set up by Loudrup. And then Gordon Jury making it 3-0 after 76 minutes. The final score at Ibrox, Rangers 3, Hearts 0.